Hello, welcome to question and answer session. Today I am back with another set of questions of February current affairs. So we will be covering the news which have occurred from February 7th to February 12th. So let us get started. Who took charge as general manager of Integral Coach Factory? Rahul Jain. Rahul Jain has taken over as general manager of Integral Coach Factory. Integral Coach Factory, it is a manufacturer of rail coaches. It is present in Chennai, Tamil Nadu. It was inaugurated by our first Prime Minister of India, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru ji, on 2nd of October 1955. So it manufactures rail coaches and it is very important. Recently, the high-speed train set, which is called as Train 21, was also started here. Who took charge as a general manager of Integral Coach Factory? It is Rahul Jain. Father Francois Laborde, who has been conferred the France's highest civilian honor, is from which state? He is from West Bengal. Francois Laborde, he has been conferred with France's highest civilian honor, that is Legion d'Honneur, which is the highest civilian order of France, in recognition of his work for specially abled children. He was entitled by French ambassador to India, Alexander Ziegler. He is the third person from the state to have been awarded Legion of Honor from Bengal state, what we are speaking about. The first one was Satyajit Ray and the second one was Soumitra Chatterjee. Satyajit Ray was awarded in 1987 and Soumitra Chatterjee was awarded last year in 2018. So this year, Father Francois Laborde has been awarded the France's highest civilian honor, that is Legion d'Honneur. The president of France is Emmanuel Macron, as we know, and the capital city is Paris and the currency is Euro. According to the 6th bi-monthly monetary policy statement 2018-19, what is the current repo rate? 6.25%. The 6th bi-monthly monetary policy review has announced that RBI had cut the repo rate by 25 basis points. In reflection to this, we can say SBI has cut the interest rate of home loans by 5 basis points. Which campaign has been launched by Swachh Bharat Mission Grameen that focuses on sustaining the open defecation-free status of villages across the country? Darwaza Band Part-2. Darwaza Band Part-2 campaign, it was launched by Swachh Bharat Mission Grameen. It focuses on sustaining open defecation-free status to all the villages across the country. The campaign, it was launched by Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation in Mumbai in the presence of actor Amitabh Bachchan. The Darwaza Band Part-2 has been supported by World Bank also. So hence it is very important. Three Darwaza Band Part-2 films, they were launched by Amitabh Bachchan and they were dedicated to readaptation of a poem of his father, late Harivansh Rai Bachchan, to the Swachh Bharat Mission. Swachh Tan, Swachh Man, Swachh Bharat or Mera Parchai. Union Cabinet has approved the proposal for the establishment of what scheme for conservation, protection and development of cows and their progeny? Rashtriya Kamadenu Ayog is a program that was approved by the Union Government for the establishment of Rashtriya Kamadenu Ayog for conservation, protection and development of cows and their progeny. So this Ayog, it will work in collaboration with Veterinary Animal Sciences of Agriculture University and also other departments in the organization of central and state government, and it will be safeguarding the cows and their progeny. Which state has approved policies for MSME and pharmaceutical sector with a view to boosting the industrial growth and attracting investment in the state? Haryana. Haryana has approved new MSME pharma policies to boost development. The state cabinet, it has approved that MSME policy 2019. It is going to create globally competitive MSMEs in the state of Haryana. 52nd Buri Boot Yullo Festival is celebrated in which state? Arunachal Pradesh. Buri Boot Yullo Festival, it is celebrated in Arunachal Pradesh. The Chief Minister of Arunachal Pradesh is Pema Khandu. The Reserve Bank of India raised the limit of collateral-free agricultural loans up to current 1 lakh with a view to help small and marginal farmers. 1.6 lakhs. Now the collateral free farm loan limit was earlier 1 lakh. Now it is raised to 1.6 lakhs. So the Reserve Bank of India, it has raised the limit of collateral free agricultural loans to 1.6 lakhs from current 1 lakh. So what is this collateral free means? You need to give something for them as a collateral. Means it is like a mortgage, what we can say. You will be giving them something, assurance we can say, in case they are failing to pay something, so they can take over the assets what they have given as a collateral. So this assets may be liquid assets or physical assets. So earlier collateral free agricultural loans without any collateral, agricultural loans were given up to 1 lakh rupees. Now to help small and marginal farmers even more better, that limit was raised to 1.6 lakhs. Indian Banking Association has marked the advisory recommendations from banks to exempt farmers from processing, documentation, inspection, ledger folio charge and various service charges for Kisan credit card loans up to how much amount? Up to 3 lakh rupees. The Kisan credit card scheme, it aims at providing adequate and timely support for the banking system under a single window. So under this, the IBA, Indian Banking Association, it has raised the limit to 3 lakhs. World's largest cashless health insurance scheme, Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana, known as Ayushman Bharat scheme. It was launched with app on Google Play Store to access scheme details recently. So what is the name of the app? PMJAY app. So the world's largest insurance scheme, Ayushman Bharat, launched mobile application, PMJAY app, known as Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana app in Google Play Store. So the scheme, it received 6,400 crore commitment from the government in the interim budget of 2019. Which payments bank announced the launch of a sweep account facility in association with Suryodaya Small Finance Bank? Fino Payments Bank. Fino Payments Bank has announced that it is going to launch a sweep account facility in association with Suryodaya Small Finance Bank. This partnership is going to help FPB, Fino Payments Bank, to address the issue of deposit limits that all the payment banks generally face. So as per RBI, the payments bank, they can only take deposits up to 1 lakh per account. Where was Air India's first ever flight simulator known as Boeing 747-200 exhibited? It was exhibited in Nehru Science Center in Mumbai recently. So Air India's first ever flight simulator, the name of which is Boeing 747-200. It is extensively used by the pilots. So until now it was used. So that was placed in the science exhibition recently. It was designed and manufactured by a Canadian firm, CAE, which was earlier known as Canadian Aviation Electronic Industries Limited, and this was acquired by Air India in 1980. What is the purpose of this artifact? The purpose of this artifact, it is to create some awareness about the significance of simulations in the field of aviation among the public in general, and also especially for the students, for them to have a glimpse of the technology. This was displayed. Which country signed an accord to join NATO to become the 30th member of US-led alliance? Macedonia. Macedonia signed an accord to join NATO to become the 30th member of US-led alliance. According to NATO Secretary General, the admittance of a new member, it highlighted that all the European nations who meet the entrance criteria could join the regional alliance. Macedonia capital is Skopje. Nepal government has made it mandatory for which country citizens who come to work in Nepal's industries and other institutions to process necessary work permits? India. Nepal government has made it mandatory for Indian citizens who come to work in Nepal's industries and other institutions to possess necessary work permits. The Department of Labor and Occupational Safety, they had issued a letter to all its labor offices across the country to finalize the actual number of Indian workers who are working in Nepal. As we know, Nepal and India are having open borders. Nepal is the only country with which India has an open border. The Indian citizens and the Nepal citizens can walk into and fro. So there is no international border line which is actually safeguarded there. So recently work permit was made mandatory for Indian workers who are working in Nepal by the Nepal government. Name the cricketer who struck the fastest 50 for India in women's T20s. Smriti Mandana. Smriti Mandana struck a half century in just 24 balls in the first T20 against New Zealand, played in the Stadium of Wellington. What is the currency of New Zealand? It is New Zealand dollar. And who is the Prime Minister of New Zealand? It is Jacinda Ardern. Jacinda Ardern. Which of the following team won the Ranji Trophy 2019 edition? Vidarbha has again won the Ranji Trophy this time. It defeated Saurashtra and it has won the Ranji Trophy 2018-19 edition. As we know, Ranji Trophy is a domestic first-class cricket championship cricket played in India. And the competition, it is named after the first Indian cricketer who played the international cricket, Ranji Singhji, who is also known as Ranji. So it is named after him. Late Lancey Naiki Vani was conferred with which award by Ranveer Singh while presenting Gallantry and Distinguished Service Awards to Army officers? Part-2 Sena Medal. Lancey Naik Nazir Ahmed was presented Part-2 Sena Medal along with some other officers and jawans. Vani is a recipient of Ashoka Chakra as well, the nation's highest peacetime award. The brave soldier who laid down his life while combating terrorists at Chiapan in November 2018. Lancey Naik Vani was conferred with Part-2 Sena Medal. The Sena Medal is awarded to members of Indian Army of all ranks for individual acts of exceptional devotion they have showed, which is very significant for the Army. So it is recently given to Lancey Naik Vani, who was appointed as CEO of Ola Fleet Technologies and COO for Ola. Puneet Birani. Puneet Birani has been appointed as CEO of Ola Fleet Technologies and also COO for Ola. Dalmia OCL, a unit of Dalmia Bharat Group, has acquired which German specialty refractory for about 122 crores? GSB Group of Germany. Dalmia OCL, it is a unit of Dalmia Bharat Group. It has acquired German specialty refractory, GSB Group GmbH, for about 122 crores. So Dalmia OCL is going to now get access to the customers. Where Dassault Systèmes did open? Dassault Systèmes did open its fifth global 3D experience executive center. At which place? It was opened in Chennai. The center, it is going to illustrate the usage of big data and analytics, including digital continuity in a global manufacturing company with advanced engineering capabilities. So Dassault Systèmes has opened a 3D experience center in Chennai. Who was honored with Kala Maharshi Babu Rao Painter Award on the occasion of the 7th edition of Kolhapur International Film Festival that was held in Kolhapur, Maharashtra? Govind Nihalani, who is a veteran filmmaker, was honored with the Kala Maharshi Babu Rao Painter Award for his contribution to the film industry recently. So the 7th edition of the film festival, it began on February 7th, 2019. In Kolhapur, Maharashtra. It is a 8-day festival in which veteran actress Rohini Hattangadi is a chief guest. The focus country of the festival is Hungary this time. So Hungarian cinema was a focus country. Government e-marketplace GEM entered into a memorandum of understanding with a statutory body to enable a fair and competitive environment in e-marketplace. So what is the body? Competition Commission of India, CCI. The Government e-marketplace GEM and Competition Commission of India, CCI, both of them, they have entered into a market, a fair and a competitive environment in the e-marketplace. So GEM is a state-of-art national public procurement platform. This is of Ministry of Commerce and Industries that has been using the technology to remove entry barriers for bona fide sellers and for creating a vibrant atmosphere for investors in India. Whereas Competition Commission of India, it is a statutory body of Government of India, which is responsible for enforcing of Competition Act 2002 throughout India and also to prevent the activities to have adverse effect on the competition. So both of them, they strive for the trade. So now together they have inked a pact for e-marketplace, online approvals, etc. Which state union territory launched the Zero Fatality Corridor project to reduce road accidents? Delhi government. The Delhi government has launched Zero Fatality Corridor project under its annual road safety action plan. This is to reduce the number of road accidents on the outer ring road stretch between Burari and Bhalaswa Chowk. State-run power giant NTPC has signed an agreement with one of the private sector banks recently for a 2,500 crore loan to part of financial expenditure. HDFC Bank. State-run power giant NTPC has signed an agreement with HDFC Bank for a 2,500 crore loan to part-finance capital expenditure. The loan it is extended at an interest rate. The MD and CEO of HDFC Bank is Aditya Puri and it is headquartered in Mumbai, the tagline of which is "We understand your world." HDFC Bank tagline is "We understand your world." What is the name of the app launched by Chennai Police Commissioner A.K. Vishwanathan by which the user can lodge a mobile theft complaint? DigiCop. DigiCop is the app which was launched by the Chennai Police Commissioner recently. The app, of now it has 18,000 stolen mobile phones that are stored in it. The user can lodge a mobile theft complaint and also check if the user's mobile is in the police list of retrieved mobiles. The first meeting of US-India CEO Forum was held in recently. The first meeting of US-India CEO Forum was announced recently. It was held in New Delhi. Which of the following animal is named as the national aquatic animal of Thailand? Siamese fighting fish was named as national aquatic animal. It is tiny and it is eye-catching, colorful, fin-plumaged Siamese aquatic fish. Why is this fish chosen? The aim of choosing this fish is to boost the conservation and breeding of the same fish. Siamese fighting fish is a native of Thailand and is mostly found in Thailand itself, so hence it is chosen. As we know, Thailand capital is Bangkok. What is the name of India's oldest captive elephant that died at the age of 88 in Kerala? Dakshayani. It was given the title of Gaja Muttashi, which means elephant granny. So it died recently. It is of 88 years old. What is the rank of India according to International IP Index of Top 50 Economies in the World, which is released by US Chambers of Commerce recently? 36. India's place was 36. This index, it ranks countries based on 45 indicators that are critical for the innovation-led economy, supported by robust patent, trademark, copyright and trade secrets protection, etc. So in that list, India has ranked 36. According to the report released by NASA and NOAA, which analysis global climatic change predicted the year 2018 as the hottest year? It is the fourth hottest year. So according to the NASA and NOAA's report, it is predicted that 5 to 9 degrees Celsius temperature in this century has increased and 2018 is the Earth's fourth hottest year on record. Which team topped in the latest FIFA rankings? Belgium is the top. Who won the EGAT Cup International Weightlifting that was held in Thailand? Mirabai Chanu. Mirabai Chanu has won this. So world champion Indian weightlifter Saikom Mirabai Chanu has notched up a gold medal at the EGAT Cup in Thailand. Chanu has won it in 48 kg category gold with an effort of 192 kgs in the silver level of Olympic qualifying event. Who was conferred with Lifetime Achievement Award by the Academy of Canadian Cinema and Television? Deepa Mehta. Deepa Mehta is going to receive Lifetime Achievement Award from Academy of Canadian Cinema and Television. Mehta is known best for her elements of triology, fire, earth and water. It is a triology written by her. She is very best known with these. Government raises the maximum time limit to a firm would be deemed eligible for angel tax exempted from 7 years to how many years? 10 years. The government has decided to raise the maximum time limit below which a firm would be deemed eligible for angel tax exemptions to 10 years from the earlier 7. So this is a recent change. In case whereas investment is going to exceed 25 crore rupees, the firm would be eligible for exemption if the angel investors can prove a net worth of 2 crores or more in the previous financial year. For investments below 25 crores, no questions would be asked. In which district did Prime Minister Narendra Modi inaugurate the new High Court circuit bench during his state visit to West Bengal? In Jalpaiguri. This is going to facilitate justice to public of Darjeeling, Kalimpong and Jalpaiguri and Cooch Behar in North Bengal. So during his day-long visit, he has inaugurated the four-laning of the Falkata Salsabari section of National Highway 31D. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi has marked a rally in West Bengal's Jalpaiguri, making it the third in the state within a week after two rallies. Second phase of river information system between Farakka and Patna, National Waterway 1, was inaugurated by Union Minister Sri Nitin Gadkari on which river? River Ganga. The second phase of river information system between Farakka and Patna, which is inaugurated by Nitin Gadkari, is on River Ganga. This second phase of river information system, it is aimed at enhancing swift electronic data transfer. How many crores had been marked for Mukhyamantri Khadyana Suraksha Yojana to provide 35 kg rice per ration card to BPL families in Chhattisgarh? It is 4000 crore rupees. Which state government has launched Kanya Sumangala scheme to provide money to all girls in the state when they get married or pass graduation? It is Uttar Pradesh government. So Uttar Pradesh government, it has launched Kanya Sumangala scheme for upliftment of women, which would give handsome money to all the girls in the state when they get married or they pass graduation. RBI has fined 1 crore rupees to which bank under section 47A of the Banking Regulation Act 1949? State Bank of India. Reserve Bank of India, it has slapped 1 crore penalty on State Bank of India for not monitoring the end use of funds with respect to one of the borrowers. So Reserve Bank of India has slapped on RBI under the section 47A of Banking Regulation Act 1949. So this is also very important. As we know, SBI MD and CEO is Rajneesh Kumar and it is headquartered in Mumbai. So in recent months, we have been seeing Reserve Bank of India penalizing all the banks with incompliance of norms. So State Bank of India has also been slapped 1 crore penalty for not monitoring the end use of funds in respect of one of its borrowers. What is the theme of 2nd ASEAN India Youth Summit 2019 held in Guwahati? The theme of the summit was Connectivity, Pathway to Shared Prosperity. Which of the following? Prime Minister Narendra Modi launched the DD channel in Itanagar. Arun Prabha. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has launched a DD channel in Arunachal Pradesh, Itanagar. So the name of the channel is DD Arun Prabha channel. Recently, the Prime Minister has visited Arunachal Pradesh and he has unveiled some development projects as well. So the worth is 4000 crore rupees for Arunachal Pradesh. He inaugurated several projects and also laid foundation stones for some schemes. Among the inaugurations was the new Doordarshan channel for Arunachal Pradesh and 50 health and wellness centers were also started in the state. US President Donald Trump and North Korean leader Kim Jong-un will meet for a second much anticipated summit in Hanoi. So what is the capital of North Korea? Capital city is Pyongyang. US President Donald Trump's second summit with North Korean leader Kim Jong-un was recently held in Hanoi. So the static details concerned with North Korea is the capital Pyongyang and currency is won and the president is Kim Jong-un. International Paralympics Committee has lifted ban on which country's para athletes under certain conditions? Russia. The International Paralympics Committee has lifted ban on Russia's athletes. In August 2016, International Paralympics Committee has suspended the Russian Paralympics Committee because it was necessary and proportionate to the situation that they faced to ensure a clean sport. Now they lifted the ban, providing the Russian Paralympic Committee to a strict criteria. Who has received the first copy of the book titled Law, Justice and Judicial Power, Justice P.N. Bhagwati's Approach? President Ramnath Kovind. President Ramnath Kovind has received the first copy of the book, so it was unveiled. The name of the book is Law, Justice and Judicial Power, Justice P.N. Bhagwati's Approach. The process of justice delivery and the idealism and simplicity of Supreme Court responding to even a petition filed on a postcard is worthy of appreciation. So the book is related to Supreme Court judiciary, we can say. Which organization won the Aegis Graham Bell Award 2018 for innovation in data science? Yes Bank. Yes Bank has won the Aegis Graham Bell Award 2018. Aegis Graham Bell Award 2018, it was announced to Yes Bank as a winner in innovation in data science category for their industry first project Yes Triple E, which means Engage Enrich Excel. This was launched at Panaji in Goa. So Yes Bank has won this award. Which country's president has been elected as the chairman of African Union recently? It is Egypt. Egypt's president Abdel Fattah El-Sisi has been elected chairman of the African Union. It was held at the Continental's Body Summit in Ethiopia. Earlier, the chair was with Rwanda. Rwandan President Paul Kagame was the head of EU. So now this year it is Egyptian President Al-Sisi. Which of the following organizations has penalized the United India Insurance for violation of regulations, circular and guidelines on rates and discounts? IRDAI, Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India. Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India has imposed a penalty, a total of 9 lakh rupees on United India Insurance, UIIC. This is for finding out that it has violated certain provisions. A sum of 5 lakhs is for violation of regulations that stipulate certain timelines was fined. And the balance 4 lakh has been fined for violations pertaining to 4 sample policies. So as we know, all the insurance companies and every firm is regulated by IRDAI, Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India. So IRDAI, it is headquartered in Hyderabad, and the chairperson of IRDAI is Subhash Chandra Kuntia. It was founded in 1999. And UIIC, United India Insurance, its headquarters are in Chennai. And the head of UIIC, the CEO, is Girish Radhakrishnan. Which social media major has acquired Grok-style virtual search startup to boost AI capabilities? Facebook has acquired Grok-style virtual search startup to boost AI capabilities in an attempt to enable users to shop better using artificial intelligence capabilities. Facebook has acquired the US-based virtual search startup Grok-style. So Grok-style is going to work into Facebook now. The basic idea of this is to allow the users to match a piece of furniture or a light fixture in an image to visually find similar ones in stock at stores. At what percent the growth rate of Himachal Pradesh is projected by Economic Survey report for 2018-19? The economic growth is projected to be 7.3% in the current financial year. The United Nations designated first ever World Pulses Day was held on. World Pulses Day is celebrated on February 10th. The United Nations, it has designated the first ever World Pulses Day, which is held on February 10th of 2019. The global event, it is aimed at celebrating pulses worldwide and the important contributions it made to sustainable food production after 2016 International Year of Pulses. It was in 2018, the United Nations General Assembly, UNGA, it has decided that it is going to celebrate February 10th as World Pulses Day. This is to keep alive the positive momentum surrounding the protein-rich and nitrogen-fixing legumes after a successful campaign. Earlier, 2016 was celebrated by FAO as an International Year of Pulses. What is the voter helpline number launched by Election Commission of India? 1950. The Election Commission of India has launched a voter verification and information program for citizens to verify their details, change the details, new registration corrections. The program, it focuses on 2019 general elections which are going to be held this year. The Election Commission of India, it has set up helpline centers in all districts in India. The voter helpline number is 1950 and they are well equipped to help callers with latest information. So why is it 1950? We know that. Because India became republic in the year 1950, so therefore they have chosen the same as a helpline number. Voter helpline application was also launched, which will help voters to check their names in electoral list, submit online forms, application status, checking and complaints filing, etc. Center has allocated 59 crore rupees for conservation of which animal in Gujarat? Asiatic lions. Lions, which are identified as one of the endangered species by the government, Ministry of Environment, they have launched a 3-year Asiatic lion conservation project in collaboration with the state of Gujarat. As we know, Gujarat is famous for the lions. There we also have Gir National Parks and Wildlife Sanctuaries. Recently, Jammu and Kashmir has granted third divisional status to which district in the state? Ladakh region. The state's government of Jammu and Kashmir, they have issued a notification for creation of Ladakh as a third division in the state. What is this division? divisional status, it is going to facilitate this region in a greater way to progress. Routine administrative clearances for Leh and Kargil, they can be obtained in divisional headquarters. Who is the governor of Jammu and Kashmir now? Satyapal Malik. Satyapal Malik. Which of the following is the mascot of 13th Conference of Parties released by Union Environment Minister Dr. Harshvardhan? Great India Bustard. The center has announced the Great India Bustard as a mascot for the 13th UN Convention on the Conservation of Migratory Species, COP13, scheduled to be held in Gujarat next year. Great Indian Bustard is a migratory species. So other important migratory birds in India, we can say it is Amur Falcons, Marine Turtles, Dungans and Humpbacked Whales. Which of the following bank has been penalized with 1.5 crore for not monitoring fund use and fraud reporting delay? Allahabad Bank. Reserve Bank of India has imposed on Allahabad Bank a penalty of 1.5 crore rupees for not monitoring end use of funds, delay in classification and reporting of fraud and non-adherence of the RBI guidelines. So for this one, Allahabad Bank has been penalized an amount of 1.5 crores. So Allahabad Bank, it is headquartered in Kolkata, and the tagline of Allahabad Bank is a tradition of trust. A tradition of trust. First time in history, Asian Development Bank had raised $100 million in international market by using which bonds? Peso-linked bonds. The Asian Development Bank, it had raised 5.22 billion pesos, which is equal to $100 million. From its maiden issue of Philippine peso-linked bonds in the international market. This is a four-year bonds. It pays a fixed interest rate of 5.25% of interest and it will be settled in US dollar. So as we know, ADB is an international development finance institution and it is also a regional development bank. Motto of fighting poverty in Asia and the Pacific. ADB is headquartered in Manila, Philippines. Which of the following participated in multinational training exercise Cutlass Express 2019, which was held from 27 January to 6th February 2019? INS Trikhand. INS Trikhand is a frontline warship of the Indian Navy. It has participated in a multinational training exercise. What is the aim of this exercise? The aim of this exercise was to improve law enforcement capacity and also regional security and progress interoperability between the armed forces of the participating nations for the purpose of interdicting illegal maritime activity in the Western Indian Ocean. So for this exercise was held with the Naval Coast Guard and Marine Police. So the ship which has participated here is INS Trikhand. Who was designated as a brand ambassador of Rajasthan Royals recently? Shane Warne. Shane Warne is an Australian former international cricketer and a former ODI captain of Australian national team. He is known as one of the greatest bowlers in the history of the game. So he retired from the international cricket in 2007 and later he started playing IPL. So now brand ambassador of Rajasthan Royals. Which of the following players scripts massive record in Hamilton, becomes first Indian to play 300 T20 matches? MS Dhoni. MS Dhoni has scripted a massive record in Hamilton. He became the first Indian to play 300 T20 matches. He achieved the milestone during the third and final T20 international match, which was held recently between India and New Zealand in Hamilton. Rohit Sharma is the second Indian on the list with 298 T20 matches. Out of 300 matches that Dhoni has played, he played 95 for India and 185 for IPL, Indian Premier League franchise, Chennai Super Kings, and the remaining 20 for presently defunct Rising Pune Super Giants. Who has clinched the Chennai Open ATP Challenger Tournament title? Corentin Moutet. Corentin Moutet has clinched the Chennai Open ATP Challenger title. Who was appointed as the next ambassador of India to the Republic of Marshall Islands? Sanjay Kumar Verma. Sanjay Kumar Verma concurrently is accredited as the next ambassador of India to Republic of Marshall Islands. So he is presently ambassador of India to Japan. Now he is going to work for Marshall Islands. For the first time in Grammy Awards history, which rap song won both the Song of the Year and Record of the Year 2019? This is America, Childish Gambino. Childish Gambino's This is America has won 4 awards. So this is the first time in history it was given both Song of the Year and Record of the Year. Lady Gaga's Shallow from the movie A Star is Born has won 2 awards. Which film won the Best Film in the 72nd British Academy of Film and Television Arts Awards? It is Roma. So BAFTA Awards, we call them in short, BAFTA, which means British Academy of Film and Television Arts. These awards were announced recently. So in these awards, Roma has won the Best Film Award. It is a Mexican black and white drama. It has registered 4 big wins. It has won Best Film, Best Director, and Best Film Not in English Language, and also Best Cinematography. And The Favourite, the 18th century set, The Favourite, it has won 7 honours. Who topped the Haran India Philanthropy List 2018 with the highest contribution of 437 crores between October 2017 and September 2018? Mukesh Ambani. Mukesh Ambani and family, they have donated 437 crore rupees from October 2017 to September 2018. So the total Indian philanthropy, it stood around 1560 crores. This is between October 2017 to September 2018. So in this list, Ambani has donated the most. Who laid the foundation stone for Greenfield Airport at Holongi, Arunachal Pradesh? Narendra Modi has laid a foundation stone for Greenfield Airport at Holongi during his Arunachal Pradesh visit, which will improve connectivity. Whose statue has been unveiled by Modi at the Maharaja Birkram Airport, Agartala? It is Modi again who has unveiled the Maharaja Birkram Airport in Agartala. The statue of whom was unveiled is the question. So it is the statue of Maharaja Bir Bikram Kishore Manikya, after whom the airport was renamed. Maharaja Bir Bikram Kishore Manikya is considered as father of modern architecture in Tripura. Which state government has inaugurated computerized mobile bus classroom called HP on Wheels? Uttar Pradesh. Yogi Adityanand, the Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, has inaugurated a computerized mobile bus classroom, HP World on Wheels, in Varanasi. So this is a computerized mobile bus classroom. This aims to drive education programs across regional, rural and remote areas of Varanasi. So they are going to bring new technologies and offer fully equipped digital tools to students. Which language is included as a third official court language in Abu Dhabi recently? Hindi. So Abu Dhabi has decided to include Hindi as a third official language used in the courts alongside Arabic and English. So the first two are Arabic along with English. So now Hindi is also going to be a language used there. Which Indian cricketer now holds the fifth position for striking the maximum number of sixes in international cricket? Rohit Sharma. Rohit Sharma has become the first Indian batsman also to smash 100 sixes in T20s. And internationally considered, he is at the fifth position for striking maximum number of crickets in the history. Name the Indian historian who won the Israel's prestigious Dan David Prize in the category Pastime Dimension. Sanjay Subramaniam has won the award in the category of Pastime Dimension for his work in macro history recently. The Meghalaya cabinet has decided to rename which stadium in Tura town after former Lok Sabha speaker Purno A. Sangma? Dikki Bandi Stadium. Dikki Bandi Stadium in the town of Tura is going to be renamed after former Lok Sabha speaker Purno A. Sangma. The 3 days Krishi Kumbh begins in which state? It has begun in Bihar, in Motihari. In Bihar, Governor Lalji Tandon and a Union Agricultural Minister Radha Mohan Singh, they jointly inaugurated the 3-day Krishi Kumbh in Motihari. Over 15,000 farmers from different states and about 200 agricultural scientists are participating in the Kumbh. What is the objective of this Krishi Kumbh? It is to promote modern techniques and diversification in agriculture that could help in doubling farmers' income. Who has become the first female winner of MRF Challenge Series? Jamie Chadwick has become the first female winner of MRF Challenge Series. That is all about the current affairs in February Part 2. See you in another bulletin. Thank you for today.